means I'm talking on the topic authority in prayer. Authority in prayer. Now, before we get into the word, I want you to rise on our feet. It affects everybody. Amen.
Amen.
There is a pastor that we preach on the radio with since last week, Friday. We can't find him. We want to pray that God should locate him and his fiance in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray for him. Let's pray for Pastor Abesori in the mighty name of Jesus. Pastor Kobe Abesori. Let's pray him on prayer. Let's pray that the Lord Jesus should cause the police and everyone that is looking for him to find him. Now, wherever his body is, wherever the enemy has taken him to, we pray that Jesus will intervene in the name of Jesus. Open your mouth and pray.
God has ordained for our life to come in.
not to cry any longer. There is a need for us not to beg any longer. We get to understand that Christ has given us authority, and we got to use that authority. Hallelujah. He says, in my name, you shall cast out devils. You shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Hallelujah. That is one of the authority. It is a sign that he has given us authority in his name to do certain things. Luke chapter 10, verse 19 to 20. I want somebody to read for me, please. Luke 10, 19, 20. Authority in prayer, huh?
I give unto you power.
Behold, I give unto you power.
Tread upon serpent and scorpions.
To tread upon serpent and scorpions.
And over all the power of the enemy.
And over all the power of the enemy.
And nothing shall be by any means.
And nothing shall by any means hurt you. Thank you. Did you hear that? He says, lo and behold, I give you power to tread upon scorpions and lions. Hallelujah. And all the power of the enemy. Did he say some of the power of the enemy? All the power of the enemy. And he says, by no means would they be able to do what? So those of us that think demons can hurt us, what are we doing? Are we believing the word of God? Or we are throwing the word of God aside, and now we are believing demons have power over our God? Hallelujah. The Bible says, if you pray, believe, that is being done. The prayer of a fervent prayer of a righteous avails much. Hallelujah. So when you pray, when you are praying, you need to exercise the authority that Jesus has given us. He said, behold, I give you power. What does power do? Huh? Do power cause people to beat you up? If you have power, do people put you on the ground and step on you? If you have power, do you cry because your enemy is insulting you? Hallelujah. If you know you have power, then when you stand to pray, stop crying. Stop begging. Huh? Make a decree. He says you shall decree a thing and it shall come to pass. Praise the Lord. The authority Christ has given us is not to beg, it's not to murmur, it's not to cry, it's not to allow Satan to cause us to be depressed and oppressed and suppressed and all the press. I can't take nonsense any longer. I can't allow the enemy to suppress me any longer. Praise the Lord. And how do you use this power? How do you use this power? Eh? Do you go and stand in front of your enemy and say, in the name of Jesus, God says he has given me power to cast you down? Is that what the power is to do? I mean, is to work for you? You see the enemy and say, hey, in the name of Jesus, I punch your face. And you punch your enemy's face. Is that how the power operates? Hallelujah. How does it operate? Open to Matthew chapter 6.